containers in the building.
Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? It's your main man, Wingdrops, and I am very excited to do this review for you guys. Gonna be a quick one. What I have here is the Evergreen Panda. This review has been a long time coming. I've been going to Evergreen Panda for years now, but I have never done a proper review on it. So I'm going to review the food here for you guys right now. I got some takeout right here. Evergreen Panda, you can get a lot of variety of foods for takeout. You can get a la carte, you can get catering plates, or you can get what I got here. They're three item plate. Inside the bag, you got, you know, your plate. Also included, I've been coming here for a long time, are the classics. You got your single napkin, you got your plastic fork, and you got the lucky soy sauce. 4-in-1. This is not the superior brand of soy sauce, by the way. There is a better brand called, I forget the exact name of it. It was like something wing soy sauce. That's the best one. But this one is locally made in San Jose, so you know it's, you know, locally made. Probably fresh. And first of all, you can tell this place is probably not the most authentic because they give you a fork and not, chopsticks. So before you expect anything, Evergreen Panda is one of your local hood Chinese spots where it's not going to be the most authentic, but it also isn't going to be the most expensive. And also, aside from the great value, you're also going to be mainly focused on takeout. It's kind of a small place, not that many places to sit, just rows of tables on the left and right, and then, you know, this is one of those places, not necessarily a sit-down restaurant. So let's get, without any further ado, let's get into it. Now look how packed my plate is. I'm experimenting a little bit this time, not getting my usual order. What I got here is their chicken chow mein. Looks really damn good. Looks like the chow mein from Chinese Express in Berkeley, with thick udon style noodles. Okay, they're not udon style noodles, but it's the thicker noodles. More thick than traditional chow mein, like the ones you get in, like, I don't know, Panda Express or something. It's just random. I also got their Kung Pao chicken and their sweet and sour pork. Sweet and sour pork is a must if you come to Evergreen Panda. I think it's one of their best dishes. Classic Chinese dish. Shout out to that one anime, I'm forgetting the name of it, where the one girl likes Chinese sweet and sour pork. But this is the good stuff, man. Overall, this plate came out to about $8. It was $7.49 before tax. So this is a great deal. It's cheaper than pretty much anywhere for a two-item plate. It's close to Evergreen Panda. I mean, I'm sorry. It's close to, what's that place called? Chinese Express in Berkeley, actually, the pricing. But they really, really packed this plate. I would say it even rivals Chinese Express, and it's much more than Panda Express, of course. It's more authentic than Panda Express, just slightly. And what's it called? Better value, it's cheaper, more food. So yeah, let's get into it. I'm very excited to try this chicken chow mein because I've never had it before. I always go with their, my personal recommendation is their barbecue pork fried rice. That one's like actually really good. It's like restaurant quality. Like it rivals Golden Buddha's chicken fried rice, or I'm sorry, barbecue pork fried rice, which is right across the street. Rip Golden Buddha, by the way. I think it's on the decline. I don't know how much longer it's gonna stay open. Shout out to Jennifer. All right, let's get into this chicken chow mein. Ooh, look at those noodles. Let me see if I can get a little piece of chicken here. Oh wow, let's get into it. Mmm. Damn, these noodles are great. It's, like I said earlier, the noodles are thick with three C's. The chicken, tasty, juicy, tender. It's that chicken thigh meat, so, you know, it's delicious. And got some veggies as well, the carrots and all this other stuff. This is excellent. I might have to convert actually from barbecue pork fried rice to chicken chow mein. This is so good. What in the world? What have I been missing? I've been going here for years and I've only been getting the fried rice because, well, of course, the fried rice was amazing. So I didn't feel like switching, but I'm glad I switched for the purposes of this video. And now I figured out a new godlike item. Now I'm going to try the Kung Pao chicken. Kung Pao chicken is one of those dishes that normally you get absolutely ripped off, where they'll give you mostly squash, celery, and peanuts, and like maybe two pieces of chicken. But when you order from Evergreen Panda, you do get a lot of chicken. It's like a good balance. So let's get into it. Chicken, slightly spicy from that Sichuan flavorings, you know. Squash, nice and squashy, tender, juicy. This Kung Pao chicken is really good, pretty solid. One of the best I've ever had. You can see that pepper right here, that dried red pepper. Delicious. Last but not least, we're gonna go into the sweet and sour pork. Now, if you're not gonna eat your meal immediately, you can ask them to give you the sauce on the side. But usually, I ordered this just not too long ago, so I got it with the sauce already on. Let's get into it. Mmm. Still crunchy, still crispy. Deliciously deep fried. There's a good amount of meat inside. And that deliciously inauthentic sweet and sour sauce. It's sweet, it's sour, it's everything you could want. Evergreen Panda is so good, especially if you eat it fresh. Oh my goodness. This is probably like one of the most inauthentic Chinese plates you can get, but it's delicious. So if you're in the Evergreen area of San Jose, California, I recommend you check out Evergreen Panda. I'm gonna have to give them a straight 4.5 out of 5 from your main Wingdrops. Close to a 5. This place rivals Chinese Express in Berkeley. Dare I say it might even be better. I was gonna nerf it. I was gonna say this was worse. But after trying this chicken chow mein, oh my goodness, that chicken chow mein was good. So yeah, really good. And also, I have to mention before I end, I got a balance plate this time, but you actually can, when you order the 3-item combination, you can order 3 of anything on their list. So you don't even have to get like a noodle. I'll show you a picture, if I still have it, of the time I ordered 3 proteins. You can, and it's the same price. Like, I think I got orange chicken, sweet and sour pork, and fried chicken wings. They still gave me in one of these plates, and it costs the same exact price. So if you want more value, quote, so to speak, you can do that also. I will mention though that this place also makes everything fresh, so if you don't call in beforehand, expect to wait like 15 minutes for your food to come out. But that's a good thing, because they always make the food fresh and it's not sitting under a heat lamp, which is why I will give this place a slight edge over Chinese Express. The food is a little bit fresher, but you do lose a little bit of that convenience factor, so there is that. But yeah, it's been your main man Wingdrops with Chinese, or with Evergreen Panda here. And we're done here.
Hi, I'm very sorry, but this video, this guy's video sucks.
It's a solid 6 out of 10. Yo, Annie, basically.
Subscribe.
Like
the video.
Yes, my friend.
It's time
to know.
That's the good one.
Mamma mia.
Mamma mia.
Bide your time and hold out hope.